So we will learn how to find quartiles. Divide the data into four equal parts. So quartiles, the symbol for quartiles equal to QK, equal to LK plus CK divided by FK times K divided by 4 times N minus total of FK, where K equal to 1 to 3. And LK here stands for lower boundary of the class QK, FK frequency of the class where QK lies, CK size of the class where QK lies, N is the total number of observation, and total of FK equal to sum of frequencies of all classes lower than the class where QK lies. And then to find interquartile range, formula is Q3 minus Q1. Okay, so you need to calculate third quartile first, and then you need to minus by Q1, okay, the first quartile. So you get interquartile range. And to find semi-interquartile range, the formula is 1 over 2 times Q3 minus Q1. Next, how to find percentiles? So divide the data into 100 equal parts. So the symbol for percentiles is PK, okay, and then the formula is LK plus CK divided by FK times K divided by 100 times N minus total of FK, where K equal to 1, 2, 3 until 99. And LK here, lower boundary of the class PK, FK, frequency of the class where PK lies, CK, size of the class where PK lies, and N, total number of observations. And total of FK is the sum of frequencies of all classes lower than the class where PK lies. Example 17, the table below shows the marks obtained by 50 students in a quiz. The maximum marks which can be obtained by any student is 10. You need to find the interquartile range. The formula to find interquartile range equal to third quartile minus first quartile, or Q3 minus Q1. Q1 or first quartile is actually 1 over 4 over total of frequency observation, and Q3 or the third quartile equal to 3 over 4 times total frequency observation. So you need to know the observation first before we find Q1 and Q3. The first quartile Q1 is 1 over 4 times total frequency. So 1 over 4 times 50. Our total frequency here is 50. So you get 12.5 observation. Alright. Add on another extra row here to calculate the cumulative frequency to indicate the observation. So 12.5 observation is located at cumulative frequency 16 here. 216 observation is right here. So 12.5 observation at mark 5. So hence Q1 equal to 5. And then the third quartile Q3, the formula is 3 over 4 times total frequency. So 3 over 4 times 50 equal to 37.5 observation. So 37.5 observation located right here. Alright. So how to read this one? Actually to 41st observation. Okay. So 37.5 observation located right here. Hence Q3 third quartile equal to 7. You take the mark, and then therefore the interquartile range Q3 minus Q1 equal to 7 minus 5 equal to 2. So interquartile range is 2 marks. Example 18, the histogram below shows the length in cm of 50 leaf. And then by selecting class intervals of 0 to 2, 2 to 4, and so on, construct the frequency distribution table from the histogram and find the median and the 80 percentile. The frequency distribution table, length and number of leaf, okay, based on the histogram. So from 0 to 2, number of leaf is 2, and 2 to 4, 2, 4 to 6, 16, and until 12 to 14, number of leaf is 4. Next, find median. You add on another row down here to find the cumulative frequency. Calculate the cumulative frequency for each class interval. Okay, by using the formula to find median, first find the observation, 1 over 2 times 50, so 25th observation located at here. So refer to the length 6 to 8, so the L2 is equal to 6. No need to find the lower boundary because this one is exclusive class interval. Okay, and then plus size add minus 6 straight away. Add minus 6, you get 2. And then frequency is 10. And then 1 over 2 times n, 50 over 2 minus total frequency. So total frequency before the median class is 20. 2 plus 2 plus 16, 20. Then using calculator, you will get 7 for the median. Next, part B, find the 80 percentile or P80. P80 means the percentage. So 80% or 80/100. First step, you need to find the observation first before you calculate the P80. So 80/100 times by n. So n here is 50 equal to 40th observation. So 40 observation located at here. Okay, so refer to this class interval, 8 to 10. So the lower boundary, L80, is equal to 8 plus class size 10 minus 8, 2, divide by frequency of F80, 10, and then times 80 divide by 100 times N, 50, minus total frequency before the F80, 2 plus 2 plus 16 plus 10 equal to 30. And then using calculator, you will get 10. So P80 equal to 10.